What's going on, gamers? Welcome to another Crimecraft stream. And you might say, oh, well, Archie O'Grady, how are you doing today? And I would say to you, I have this emptiness in my heart. This vast emptiness in my heart that, I don't know, I'm yearning for something. I still see that mic peaking. I'm gonna fix it while I talk. So I have this emptiness in my heart, dear viewer. And you might say, oh, well, that's sad. You should go to therapy. And I'd say, no, that's for losers. What are you, stupid? What do you think I'm gonna sink $100,000 million into my mental well-being? Stupid. I have a better idea. I'm gonna go find a gorilla in Minecraft. And I'm gonna take him home, and I'm gonna give him lots of bananas, and we're gonna be friends. We're gonna be chums. Close buddies, chumarinos, home slice, bread slice dogs, if you will. Except he won't be a dog, he'll be a gorilla. But the only dog I'll be is the one that's in me. So let's cut the chatter, shall we? Let's cut the chatter. I'm gonna turn this slightly down. There we go. I think that's good. Now let's hop onto Crimecraft and see what's what. What's going on over here? Oh, I don't have it at full screen. That's my bad. It rarely happens, but it is my bad. How's that look? There we go. You'll love to see it. Okay. Here we are on the Crimecraft server. And yes, look. All right, let me... We'll get to that. We'll get to that in a second. Let me walk you through what's been going on. Did some off-camera assembly of my little book nook. My Kindle corner, if you will. My enchantment corner, where I'm gonna do all my enchanting of this armor. Which reminds me, I need to make a grindstone, because right now, my armor isn't great. It's kinda, you know, you take what you can get. Especially since it was a gift from, I think Vinsoli gave it to me. Or a number of parties. By given, I mean, I think Vinsoli stole some diamonds from Zweet and then passed the evidence on to me. That's what I mean by given. So, you still take what you can get, though. Let's just cook this real quick. Pop that in there. Grab one of these. Put this in the cooker. I got a system, you see. All right, grab our water back. All right, we'll wait for that to cook. And let me grab some sticks. I think I need two. And what else did it say? I needed planks. Luckily, I've got plenty of planks. There we go. All right, so we'll make a grindstone just for this armor. And there's a secret. I've discovered something on the server. Hello. I forgot about you. I forgot about the crab. I don't know how I feel about the crab on the head. It's a nice little buddy. I won't lie. But I think it's outlived its time. We'll have to find a new hat for today. There we go. Our stone's done cooking. Let's pop this in here. There we go. And now, bada bing, ba da boom. Awesome. Got a grindstone. Let's put this just in the corner here. That's good. All right. So now we'll just disenchant all of this. Not that it's really too enchanted to begin with. Sorry, it was very, very kind, a very courteous deed and nice public service to give me this armor. And I'm going to appreciate it by not allowing it to perish. It's gonna do that, I knew it. So I'm gonna slap some mending on this and I will show you how. Because it might be like, oh, Archie, it's a zombie apocalypse. There's no mending villagers. And I'd call you stupid for that because little did you know. But yeah, I finished this corner and I have a bunch of maps from last stream's project, which was assembling Hannibal Burris just out on the floor here. And these are all the maps of just like empty space. But I also just decided to put Kevin James here because I like Kevin James. I think he's a funny guy. One of my favorite movies is Paul Blart Mall Cop. I'm a fan. I'm a big fan. And you know that. You know that Paul Blart Mall Cop was one of my favorite movies if you followed me on Letterboxd. which you can do so by, where's my freaking socials button? I had it bound. Does that work? Yes, it does. So you could click that link and I put Letterboxd on my card. Isn't that special? Isn't that sweet? But all right, there we go. Enough yammering for now, I think. Is anybody on? No, they're not. Perfect. 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 That means I have adequate time and resources to execute today's plan. Oh, yeah. Before we go out and just be stupid and not have a plan, let's write down what I have to do today. So it'll pop out the to-do list. Let's write down what we have to do today. So I want to find a gorilla. Find gorilla. That's number one. Then I need mending books. At least four. There's no real... I can't, like, underline the less than sign to do the mathematical notation or whatever. Then I need to... Actually, all right, I'll probably do this first, but build gorilla enclosure. There we go. And I think that's it for now. Oh yeah, I need lapis lazuli. Lazuli. Lazuli? Lazuli? I have no idea. All I know is that the way I say it is right. And that's what matters. We'll just put this up here, have it. That's a pretty good size. It's pretty out of the way. There we go. I'll make it a little bit smaller. Make it a little bit smaller. There. That's nice. I like that. All right. So that is what we have to do today. We have some very simple tasks. I think it's like four very simple tasks. Let's just knock one out of the park immediately. And I think I'm going to focus on finding lapis lazuli first, because I think that's going to be the relatively easy one. And by that, I do not mean, oh, I'm going to go down to the mines. I'm going to go down to the mine shaft like we did in days of yore, and I'm going to find lapis lazuli all by myself. No, I'm going to just rifle through these chests, because I know they have some. All right, I just have to find where it is. Raw, that's stuff. Plant, pets of overworld. Okay, that's like animal drops. That's blocks. Okay. It might be upstairs, because I think that's where they keep their more valuable stuff. Oh, here's some. I'll take half for now. Because I don't know how much I'm going to need, but I'll take half for now. We'll see. We'll see. It's probably going to be a lot more than that, I'll be honest. But that's good for now. So honestly, really productive. We're being really efficient and productive already. Look at that. Already, we can take our to-do list and just... scratch off lapis lazuli. It's gone. It's done. Look at that. Beautiful. All right, so that first task is done. Now, let's just take this back home so I don't die and drop it and lose it forever. Now, I want to stake out a nice location for a gorilla enclosure. Because you might be wondering, Archie, why are you finding a gorilla? And to that, I'd say, why aren't you? Are you stupid? Let's just inconspicuously make sure nobody notices us doing this. Whoa, that's crazy. How did I get into that secret hidden... What? Whoa. I just went into a pocket dimension. I have no idea what just happened there. That's so wild and wacky and crazy. I have no idea what happened. Let's take some blocks. Do I have a stack of cobble? I like having a stack of cobble on me. That's good. That works. Yeah, a little bit more. All right, so we've got our lapis and we've got it stored safely away. Let's go ahead and go to the mall. No, let's stake out where we're putting our gorilla, because I need a friend. And that's why. First of all, let me give you the backstory. If you weren't here for the first Crimecraft stream, then you would have missed this, the event that caused this. Here lies gorilla. Friend, I wish I had a flower so I could pay my respects. But I do have a lantern. There. Respects have been paid. You were a good friend, gorilla. And you're like, oh, so you're getting a gorilla to replace your old gorilla? No, stupid. Gorilla was an elephant. I'm getting a gorilla so I can name it elephant and have perfect symmetry. That's what I'm doing. So that's the plan. That's why I want a gorilla. And also, partially because I've just seen gorillas wandering about. So I think it's going to be kind of easy to get one. But I think the harder thing to get is bananas. That would be if I... Ooh, wait. I was thinking of getting bananas by going to a jungle biome, since that's how you get them. You take the leaves, you break them, and they drop bananas sometimes. Do I have bananas in here? No, of course I don't. But I do happen to know where a large sum... What was that? Was that in the music? Probably was. Am I going crazy? I know where a large sum of bananas are. I just realized that. And they've been there since day one. That's right. That's right. You know what I'm talking about. The Church of Jesus. Yes. The ultimate deterrent. Deterrent? The ultimate deterrent of blood moons. And the ultimate way to appease Jesus, whose will is supreme in this world, is bananas. Jesus loves them. And so, people bring bananas here to pay tribute to Jesus. A very noble cause, a very just cause, very selfless cause. I'm going to steal from the church, and I'm sure there's some official term for what kind of crime that is, but, you know, I helped found the church, I'll have you know, so it doesn't really matter. Oh, I'm losing hope. I'm losing hope. Wait. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. There's no bananas here. I was misled. Where's the bananas? You did this to me, didn't you? You did this on purpose. You knew I'd be coming in today. You knew I'd be coming in today with the purpose of finding... You have nostrils. I just noticed that. They look very nice. Good job. You knew I'd come in here today with the sole purpose of finding bananas so I could get a gorilla friend. And you just had to hide him from me. Unbelievable. I know you're all powerful and are Jesus and all that, but throw a guy a bone once in a while, man. All right, so we do have to get bananas the hard way then. Unless we miraculously find them somewhere else in this world, which is possible. I gotta go to the jungle and I gotta find my own bananas, which is kind of nuts when you think about it. All right, well, finding bananas is gonna be harder to do. That's the way it is. Some things will never change. You think they want baked potatoes? Do you think if you were a gorilla and I came up to you with a baked potato, you'd say, "Oh, normally I'm kind of a banana guy, but since you've got taters on the table, I just might have to change my preferences." You think that'd happen? I think it might. Let's take a nap. Take a little middle of the day, end of the night nap. And then we'll go snooping around. Let's go explore the jungle. Let's put on our armor, first of all. Not the nice armor that I don't want to damage. Let's put on some relatively garbage armor. Let's find a hat for today. What should I wear? I don't want to wear the RGB Jesus hat, because I'm kind of mad with him right now. I won't lie to you. He took all the bananas, and he knew I needed them. So I'm kind of pissed with Jesus. I could take sheep hat. What do gorillas think of sheep? Do they like sheep? I don't know. Is there a banana hat? That'd be fitting for today. Shunka. Cool. Chef's hat. We're not cooking the bananas. We're just using them. Springer. Jerry Springer? Who put Jerry Springer on my Minecraft game? Oh, hello. What are you? What is this guy? I have no idea what this is. This is definitely like some video game reference. I could just have him. Wait a minute, he's like a little guy. That's cool. Okay, I'll keep Springer in my offhand then. And what should we have? Let's look on the shelves. Bananas. What screams bananas to me? Lake Doctor. Ooh, wait, no, it's all too much. Let's just put on the beanie. This is a really weird looking beanie, by the way. It doesn't look like one at all. If anything, this looks like more of a beanie. All right, let's put on the beanie. Gosh, I look like a Tom Shelby from the hit show Tom Shelby's Adventures in Chicago. Yep, That's it. All right, let's check out the jungle. I'm pretty sure it's over this way, I think. We spawned in a jungle. We spawned nearby a jungle. That's where the world spawn is. I know that. But I think it extends over this way. Yes! That's a jungle. All right, let's cross over here. Ooh, let's rifle through Gord's stuff. Because I know, I mean, since they live there, you would think they have a fair share of bananas of their own, right? Be kind of bonkers if they didn't. So let's check that out. Let's check out Gord's chests. Normally, I don't really condone any sort of thieving. Hello. I'll be back for you, big boy. All right. Sorry, that was way too. I didn't mean anything by that. I want a gorilla for normal reasons. For normal reasons. Ah, dang it! They locked me out. They tried to stop me, but I'm a machine. I can't be stopped. All right. Armor, nether drops of wood, dirt, cobblestone. What's this? Shh. Gord's trying to. I'm taking one of these, by the way. And I'm also taking one of these. Oh, wait. I'm going to take the unused one. Sorry. There's no way I'm using other stuff. What is this? These are all like modded items. That's interesting. What would you use these for? I think you'd use the rocky shell to make the rock and roller chest plate. That's what it's called, right? Rock shell chest plate. Okay, what do you use the rest of this for? Fish bones. There's some weapons I've seen that have definitely come from fish. There's no denying it. Blobfish. That's right. There are blobfish, aren't there? All right, that's cool. But I can't get too distracted. I'm here with a mission. And that mission is finding bananas. What is this? Stinkray. Are you a fish? Okay, it's a fish. I thought it was like an actual ray, like the fart gun from the hit movie Despicable Me. Tree nature, animal drops. Holy. That's a lot of sticks. What do you mean tree nature? Just label it sticks. Even with bamboo, you'll still know there's sticks in there. Because it's all sticks. Image. Oh, it's just a map of the area. That's cool. Oh, this is what the bone stuff is made of. I see. They're useful against Sons of Sins. That's interesting. Sons of Sins. What is a son of sin? I know what the sins are, because I have been killed multiple times by sins. What do you think? Huh? This is a good persona for me? I don't know. It doesn't speak to me, you know? It's not me, really. The real me. Alright. No bananas in there. Let's go to another floor. Hello, Gordo F-150. Hope you've had a nice day. Look at this stuff. Okay, they have to have bananas. They have literally every other kind of food. They have to have bananas. It'd be absolutely wacko crazy if they didn't. Never even... Okay, I've seen Beefman's hat. I just don't know what it looks like. Wow. That's a good hat. I enjoy that. So can you make custom hats with the mod? Looks like it. That's cool. That's very cool. I won't steal that though. Sombrero. Hello? Oh, it's an actual... Oh, shoot. Oh, that's hard though. Okay. I like that. I'm a fan. I might have to figure out how to get one of those for me. Because, man. Oh, wow. That's a full one. That's a full sack. So that's even bigger than Hannibal was. Hello. Just looking for bananas. Totally normal guy. Gosh, Gord, you keep so many empty chests. Why? There can't be a good reason. A good justification for this many empty chests. Just a waste of wood, isn't it? Drop four. I mean, they're not using it, are they? I'll come back here. I'll keep this place in mind. Looks like a farm. I don't know how it works. So they spawn and they come down here, and what, you crouch over here and you swing at them from here? That's inefficient. Maybe I'm misunderstanding how it works, but hang on, adventurers. Hang on. Let's check this out. What is this? Okay. No redstone or anything connected here. That's probably safe. Is this meant to be like a puzzle trap? I'm just gonna run across it. I'm just gonna run. Oh, it's fine. It wasn't a trap of any kind. That's okay. That's cool. Just jump over that one just to be safe, though. I guess they don't use the rest of this building. Oh, this is a nice floor. Wait a minute. I haven't seen this part yet. Wow, nice mossy floor. Hello. So I guess they do use some of the floors. Or maybe, oh, maybe the mossy floor is like the ceiling. Let's check what the floor is under it. Is it like for a habitat? It might be. No, it's just grass. It's just a mossy carpet. Did Gord do this or is it just like this? Is it just like this for real? Okay, I think they have a purpose with this because they intentionally put torches in the ground for lighting and they left it like that. So I think they have a plan for that. I'm interested to see what it's going to be. Very interested to see what that's going to turn out to be. But no bananas. No bananas at Gord's Joint. Very disappointing. Very disappointing. Because it kind of means that we have to go out. We gotta go oot in a boot, and we gotta check out for some bananas. Because I really don't know the better way to do this. First of all, I'm gonna say a prayer. Say a real quick prayer for Jesus. Sorry. I'll be right back. I got a thing to do. I got a thing to do. You'll understand. When I come back and I tell you what it is, you will understand. Be right back. Sorry, I'm back. It was very pressing. Very pressing and important matter. You would have been very disappointed in me if I missed it. And by that, I mean I had to poop. You understand. You understand. All right. Let's get back into it. Let's get right back into it. I can't see. Oh, it's the terracotta that I put around myself. Makes sense, I guess. It was there before. All right. Where are we getting our nanners from? Well, you know what? Let's go see if we can find that house again. There was somebody who set up shop in a building this direction. Oh, wait. Oh. Kind of never mind. Because I want to go this way. Boo! Ah! Sorry, you scared me. Welcome, Procyon Paws. How are you doing on this fine day? Ooh! Nice potato farm. Very nice potato farm. Holy. There's probably some proper method to this, but I don't know what it is. Let's go home. Let's go sleep. Great, just quit my job? Okay, that must be... You're saying you're great. That must be a good kind of quit my job. Good for you. Good job. I'm sure it's usually a difficult thing to do. So I'm... Whatever the reason, good for you. It sucked. Well, I'm glad you're out of there now. You're a free person. Freedom. Enjoy the freedom you are granted as a human being. Ow. Oh yeah, let's say hi to the fish. Hello. Hello. Quit once before, went back and quit again. You're like a stupid fella who goes back to his garbage ex. Sorry, that was mean, but also true. Wait a minute. Where's Geralt? Wait. Where is he? Where's my favorite man? He's not here. He's not here. I needed money, okay? Get a different job, man. Where's Geralt? Geralt's not here. I don't remember what his name was. Was it Geralt? Geralt? He's not here. That's what matters. The big old catfish. He's gone. They killed him. The CIA got him. It's the best paying one where I live. That's unfortunate. Yeah, there's always caveats to stuff like that. Like, oh, it's the best paying job, but oh, they have to cut off a piece of your skin every time you fail to make a sale. And I don't feel tired enough to sleep. Isn't that incredible? What a wonderful mechanic, and I love it. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Almost. I was close in my estimate. Well, I can't sleep. So I guess I gotta do the old-fashioned method of finding bananas, which is looting. Just rifling through every chest I can find. Which means school time. Nice. Yes. Hone in your focus on your education. You too can be like this capuchin monkey smoking a fat dart. That could be you. Hello, dog. I pressed the button just for you. Hello, dog. I don't have any meat on me. I wish I did. Hello, kangaroo named Roo. Very nice. Very creative. See, this is the goal. But I'm going to give my... I forgot about this creature. Bun fungus. Is that what he's called? Is he a bun fungus or is he a... He's a bun fungus. Okay. What are you? What? From what realm do you hail? What realm are you from? Okay, wait. The texturing on its back kind of reminds me of... Hello. Hello, Morgana. Nice to meet you. This is a temporary pond for Merlin. Please don't kill me, Zoot. Merlin? She's going around in circles. Oh, winding it back. Merlin's a hardcore. Oh, he's a drifter. It's like Fast and Furious in here. Love this guy. The pattern on Jeff's back reminds me of the rocky roller thing that it drops the stuff that you make with the rock chest plate. Oh, sorry. Sorry, Jeff. Did I overstep my bounds? I'm sorry. Then you got Inigo Montoya, who's being so... He's just tied up like this. And I'm not doing my man like that. I'm building my gorilla a proper enclosure. As soon as I steal. stuff for him. Okay, well, Bluette House has a gorilla, so surely they have bananas. Natural stuff? I would call bananas precious, but they're not in there. Bananas, 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 bananas. This is wood. But you never know. You never know. Dang. No bananas everywhere. Like a month ago, it used to be that everywhere you looked, in every chest on this server, you would find bananas. Oh, speak of the devil. Thank you. Thank you, Bluette House. Much appreciated. I gotta leave them like an IOU. That's probably like the morally right thing to do for all the stuff I've stolen from them. But nah, it's fine. You're like a minion. Oh, because I was about to say, what the hell did you say to me? Get out of here. But no, I get it. The bananas, I understand. I understand. I like Stuart. He's the one I relate to the most. When that movie came out, when Minions 2015 came out, I related to Stuart the most. I would watch that movie all the time. Am I tired enough now? I'm not. That's so stupid. How does that even work? Last time I thought it was because of, like, oh, a blood moon's about to start. You can't sleep. What are you, stupid? But no. No blood moon ever started last time it said that for me. And I don't think one's going to start now. So I don't know what the you don't feel tired enough to sleep is. I have no idea. Bob, though, he's pretty great. I'm not discrediting any of the other minions, but Stuart, he's chill. Just chill guy. I like him. I vibe with him. Mess with him. He is a mood indeed. Indeed. Alright, well, we can't sleep, so we might as well build. It's gonna be a skeleton of an enclosure. But it's gonna be an enclosure nonetheless. Okay. Let's just grab some more cobble. Ooh, I've got so much cyan terracotta, I might as well use this. That'll work. Alright. And I'll probably need fence gates, like four, at least four fence gates. So let's grab some wood, grab some sticks, craft up some fence gates. Is it? Hang on. I'm going to show you how I remember the orientation. It's this. This is fence gates. Has to be. Yes. 3, 4. There we go. Beautiful. We got our gates. We got our blocks. Very nice. All right. Let's build this enclosure. Oh, it's daytime. That's awesome. First, we got to find somewhere to do it. Maybe I could put my, I'll put my armor away since it is now day and I'm in the safe zone. I'll put it away. We are not in danger. We are the danger. Put the lead away now too, just so we have more room and an inventory for stuff and things. All right, let's see. I'm thinking of putting the enclosure right here. I don't know if people use these trees. I did yesterday. But there is also a whole tree farm over yonder. But I don't know that they have acacia. I don't think they do. Rare parrot? Oh, is that an emote that I just don't have on my phone? Because I don't have, like, better TTV on my phone. Let me look at it. No, it's not even showing up for me on OBS. Interesting. Very interesting. Oh, wait. Did I do a thing? Mending books? Nope. Not yet, but we're building the gorilla enclosure now. That's the task we're working on now. Very cool. All right. Let's do this. It showed on stream. That's good. Okay, I'm glad. Just didn't show up in my chat, but I'm glad it showed up there. Let's see. Yes. I'm gonna take off my pants. Skill issue. Hey, man. Uncalled for and evil. Yes. Okay, it seems like a path. I don't think I could violate currently existing paths. So I think this is it. I think this is my land. I think this is it. Or do we put him in the basement? I feel like it's going to be a lot harder to get him downstairs, but maybe that's what we have to do. Well, I don't know. All right, let's think about this. I'm going to cut down these trees while I think about it. And I'm going to go craft an axe because this one's about to break. Let's see. So I can leave some acacia saplings by the tree farm if there are people who want acacia wood. Can't imagine why you would. It's a very garbage wood. That's not true. It's very underrated. People hate on it way too much. That's what I'll say about acacia wood. Oh, I already have sticks. And I already have stone. Beautiful. All right, so let's go like this. Go like this. I did it again. Ugh, that's gross. Crafted it backwards again. I don't know what's come over me these past couple of days. I just crafted a stone axe backwards again. That's evil. It really is. All right. Well, let's cut down these trees and think about it. So, I probably will put the acacia with the tree farm so that people can use it. Which, again, don't know why they would. There's a lot of perfectly good woods that aren't acacia that you could use. But, you know, to each their own. To each their own. And let's see. I guess. But do I want it to be big? How big do I want this enclosure to be? I want it to be spacey. I want it to be roomy. And I want it to be comfortable for Elephant. That's what his name is, by the way. The gorilla's name is going to be Elephant. And if you don't know why, it's because, like, on the first day of this server, we found an elephant. And Beefman said, oh, is that a gorilla? And so we named it Gorilla. So now I'm going to pay tribute to said gorilla. Oh, yeah, said elephant by naming Gorilla Elephant. You understand. There we go. So that's that water gone. Let's clear out this area. I guess I could take up, you know what? I'll just cut out the middle for now. We'll have this be like the ring that we keep it inside of. Not the horror movie where the girl comes out of the TV. Like the basis of our build. The area in which we're going to build this enclosure. You get it. All right. How is there a flower growing on the stone? That's interesting. Take off my pants. There we go. Bye, flower. All right. Let's see. Magic. Probably. There's a lot of weird things in witchcraft going on this server. Like, I talked about this earlier, but there's a gamut of mods on this server, and a lot of them I don't know about because I was just told to, add this folder to the Curse Forge launcher. So I'm like, okay, and I did it. So I don't really know the full extent of what mods are on here, but I have experienced some of them in the wild, and it's been interesting. I'm so glad that I don't know. I'm so glad that I'm so ignorant to what is going on the server, because it makes everything new that I discover a surprise, and it's awesome. It wasn't awesome when I went out and I found a massive, like, floating stone castle. I'm like, whoa, that's a massive stone castle. That's badass. I'm going to go explore it. So I went and explored it, and one of the seven deadly sins was in there, and I died. That was less enjoyable, I will say. I didn't like it as much. But other stuff on the server's great. Like some of the animals I've seen, they're cool. They're chill. I like them. All right, we've got our saplings. Put that away. I don't need this. Don't need these as much. Archie sees stone castle. Is that a stone castle? Well, I was wondering. All right. You're telling me you see something, you don't go, oh, is that that thing that it is? Is that a me thing? That might be a me thing. It's entirely possible. Speaking of me things. Of course I do. What am I, heathen? Okay, great. There we go. That's what I thought. All right. There. What was I going to say? I said speaking of me things, not having a plan. Oh, yeah. I was thinking about this earlier today. We haven't had a Nintendo Direct in a minute. Or I don't remember what the last one was, but I remember people didn't really care for it too much. They were like, it sucked. The only good Nintendo Direct was the one where they announced Mario Wonder, which I still have to play, by the way. I still have to play that. I won't stream it, but maybe I'll make a YouTube video on it. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how it all turns out. But I was thinking, one of the main things that people always ask for when a new Nintendo Direct comes around, they're like, Nintendo, you lazy bums, make Tomodachi Life on the Switch. And they never do. But you don't know that they're not working on that, you know. Because they made an incredible, like, Mii Maker with the Switch port of Miitopia. That's what got me thinking about it. And, oh, wait, I do... I was about to say, I never played the Switch port of Miitopia because I didn't own a Switch when it came out. But I own a Switch now. So maybe in the future I'll play that. I played through Miitopia and beat it on my 3DS, and that was fun. Loved it. You know what I'm getting? I'm gonna stream hopefully December. Baldur's Gate, getting it for Christmas. That's cool. That's very nice. Yeah, I've been thinking about playing Baldur's Gate. There is a friend who said he'd help me. Thank you. Hang on. I can't see anything. Thank you for the follow, whoever you are. I'm sorry, my stream manager is like messed up. I can't see things. Thank you for the follow though, I appreciate it. Don't play a lot of Nintendo, but I love me some Mario Kart. Indeed. That Mario Kart is like the one game that's like relatively competitive where I'd say I am genuinely good at it. Hello, clown. Thank you for the follow, clown. I appreciate it. Welcome. I'm glad you're here. Yeah, I have a tragic story to tell about Mario Kart, by the way. I always thought I was the best at Mario Kart. And to this day, I still do think I'm the best at Mario Kart, you know? So, I thought in my first semester of college, I was like, oh, the music department, they're putting on a Mario Kart tournament. Why don't I enter that? And, you know, it'd be a great way to meet people and, you know, also show off how incredibly good I am at Mario Kart. I'm a Toad main, by the way. It's the best character. And, there's nothing else to say about that. But anyways, I'm a Toad main, I play Mario Kart, and I enter into this brand new tournament at my college. So I show up. I'm ready. There's a lot of people there. There's a whole tournament bracket. They've got all the players who joined in. I think there was also like a prize. There was like a $5 entry fee. So I paid the fee on Venmo. I had to make a Venmo for that. I didn't have one before. Tanuki Mario though? True. No. Why am I saying true? No. Toad stays on top. Toad stays winning. So anyways, I entered the tournament and there were so many people there. And I'm not great. I'm not what you would call a socialite. I'm not Joe Cool in that area, you know? So, so I was like, okay, well, I'll at least try to communicate with people, like, you know, when I'm not racing. Because I was the first one up. I was part of the first race, and there was three people per race. So there was three people per race, and it was me and somebody who'd never played Mario Kart before and another person who I didn't really know. So I thought, okay, yeah, I'll get a great chance to talk to people when I have this race in the bag, because obviously I do, you know. It's just these two people who, obviously, I could do so much better than. So, we did a Grand Prix. First race comes around. I'm the only one standing up. They had these chairs put in front of the TV. The two of them sat down. I stood up behind my chair, because I cannot play Mario Kart sitting down. It has been that way ever since the first time I played Mario Kart, because I was so used to playing Wii games standing up, like Wii Sports Resort and Wii Fit, and I just got used to playing Wii games standing up. Obviously, you know, I play other... I've gotten used to, you know, like, sitting down and gaming, because, like, I got it... The gradual integration of, like, oh, I'm playing Super Mario Bros. Wii, and so I sit down for that, and now I... sit around all day on a computer playing Minecraft. So I made the switch eventually. I gotta find a moss block. That's what I'm thinking, is I need a moss block, but I'll just put dirt there for now. So I go there and I stand up. I'm behind the chair and they're like, oh, you don't want to sit down? I'm like, no, this is my method. Trust me. Watch this. Let me tell you something about that, folks. Every time I say watch this. And I say it a lot, and I feel really stupid for saying it, because every time I say, watch this, I fail miserably. But But I was like, yeah, I'm fine. Watch this. So we started the game. And I was doing okay, you know. It was just a three-person race. So they didn't add any, like, CPUs. There were no computer players. It was just the three of us. So that was something I wasn't used to. I was used to having computer players. And it was also, it was on, I think it was on 100cc, which I'm also not used to. I always play 150cc. I've got the three-star gold trophies on all of them in Mario Kart 8, and not to brag. But we're playing 100cc, and I don't remember what the first one was. I don't remember what cup it was either. I think it might have been, I don't remember what it's called, 200cc. I've heard good things about 200cc, and it makes me want to try it. Like, really, really bad. I really want to try 100cc, 200cc. I just haven't gotten around to it. I'm going to just liberate a single moss block. I'm sure they won't mind. But, yeah, I wasn't used to that, which was fine. I was like, okay, you know, it's slower. I can adapt and conquer. So I do the first race, which I think it's on that one map where it's like everything's made out of ice cream and the cones. I think the track itself is like pretty much Laffy Taffy. I don't remember what it's called though. The cones are like candy corn, I think. I don't remember. There, just need one. And I get second place, which in a race of three people is smack dab in the middle. And you know, like Ricky Bobby said, if you ain't first, you're last. So I was not satisfied with that one. I remember distinctly what the next course was. It was Dragon Driftway, and I was in the second slot. And I was like, okay, this time I'm coming for blood. This time I've got it for sure. And you know what? I did. I lapped them. I was so far ahead. I was like, it took like, if you counted it out, maybe 30 seconds when I finished first, 30 seconds to the next one. To the next person to finish. You know what Laffy Taffy is? Oh yeah, Laffy Taffy, you know what Taffy is? Laffy Taffy's like a, gosh, I don't know how to explain it. It's sticky stuff. It's a candy, you eat it. It's sticky, it's really sugary, really sweet. I don't know how to explain it better than that. I figured there was Taffy at least. Not Laffy Taffy specifically, but at least Taffy everywhere in the world. That's interesting. All right, let me get some bones. I need to mossify all that dirt I just placed down. Sticky stuff, yeah, of course, yeah. Yeah, you get it, you understand. All right, so then I absolutely dominate on Dragon Driftway. Takes them a whole 30 seconds after I finish for them to finish in second place. And at this point, I'm feeling hot. I'm feeling cocky. I'm not feeling tired enough to sleep. And so I'm like, all right, this will be fine. I'll do the next race and I'll win. Then I can start, you know, start a casual conversation with some people maybe. And, you know, get to know some folks. Have a great time. Next race. I get third. I don't remember what the course was, but I got third. So in that whole arena, in that whole time that I was doing my thing, that whole Grand Prix, I got every place, but that didn't matter because when the points stacked up, I got last overall. So what I thought was a surefire thing and what I thought was going to be like, oh, I could just beat this real quick and I'll go and talk to some people and then I'll just wait for like the real competition to start when they get all the easy folk out of the way. But man, was I wrong. That was kind of stupid of me to say. So yeah, I lost. Didn't really get to talk to too many people because, you know, the table that I was sitting at, it was their turn to go next. I gotta light this up up a lot better. Let's just put some lanterns on it for now. So yeah, that's my last tragic Mario Kart story. To be honest, I don't think I've played much Mario Kart since. I might have played a bit of Mario Kart 7 just like on the road on occasion on my 3DS, but that was it. Can I not place lanterns on leaves? That's interesting. Let me at least get rid of these leaves. Let's see what I can do about this. How about the leaf situation? Aha! Couple of pesky logs up here. What was I talking about before? I was talking about Tomodachi Life. Yeah. Everybody's talking about how, oh, they've got this incredible meme maker for Miitopia, which I did beat. That was awesome. It was great. Why don't they just use it for Tomodachi Life where it would be actually useful? And I'm sure they're thinking about it. I'm sure they've at least shot the idea of a Tomodachi Life remake around. I mean, it was a massive game when it came out. I only got it recently on my 3DS. And I do enjoy it. I don't really log on as much as I did when I first got it. Why am I putting that in there? I meant to put the saplings. There we go. Just to be a good, courteous community member. But yeah, I do think that having that advanced Mii Maker would be perfect for Tomodachi Life. Especially, like, if you don't know what I'm talking about, let's Google, like, Miitopia Switch Mii Maker. Something like that. It's incredible. People have made, like, some of the most creative things with it. It's awesome. Like, not hyper-realistic, but a lot more realistic than the old Mii Maker was. Like, you have so many more options. Like, you used to be really limited with your facial placement and your hair color and everything. But now, it's incredible. And I don't know why they don't, like, translate it over, make that the official Switch Mii Maker. Which doesn't make sense. They're losing money. All right. There we go. That's our base. I want Gorilla to feel at home. I want him to feel nice and cozy. No, his name's Elephant. His name's Elephant. I gotta drill that in my mind. All right. So that's that. Maybe we put some Podzol down. I don't have like Silk Touch though, so I don't know how I would do that. It's small. This is small to you? It's a lot better than what they have over at Bluey's house, that's for sure. He'll enjoy it. He's got this whole... I'm including this part. Yes, it's small? Really? Interesting. Well, I will be including this part of it. So it's slightly larger than this. I gotta get some more carpets, that's fine. Alright, what to do next? What to do next? Let's think about this logically. Let me get a bird's eye view of this real quick. Let me go on top of Monkey Mayhem's lawyer building. Let's see. Oh my gosh. Did they intentionally make it difficult to climb? Are they still working on this? I have no idea. Chat, I have no idea who Monkey Mayhem is. I don't think anybody does. But oh, whoever they are, I don't think they're well acquainted with the mods on this server. Because Emily Ann TV's got her chairs over there, her proper comfy chairs. But Monkey Mayhem has stone. Interesting. Okay. I have no idea who they are. And I've never seen them before. I only found out that they were a real person when I watched Gordius's most recent video. I thought it was like somebody pretending to be somebody, pretending to have a secret other identity. But no, it's a real person. All right, so let's think about this. If I were a gorilla, what would I want in my ideal enclosure? In this specific grid, what would I put here? I would want a jungle tree. Monkey Mayhem's great. I've met them before. Met them, like, spoken with them or just interacted with them in the game, or like have you exchanged words like with voice, or have you existed in the same space? Because I don't know anything about them. All right, so let's find, do you need 4 saplings, not with voice? Okay, so they really are a mystery to everybody. That's cool. They talk with a book. Oh, that's actually very cool. I like that. It's like 2013 Minecraft talking with signs, kind of, but like with a book, which is more convenient. Let's be real. But that is neat. I like that. All right, do you need 4 saplings for a jungle? I don't think so. Is that jungle over there? Yeah, that's jungle wood over there. So you only need 1 sapling for a jungle tree. So let's go grab one of those. or I might have one just in my base somewhere. I'll check over here. I'll drop off these remaining acacia saplings as well, just in case. Again, I know not a lot of people like acacia, but come on. All right, just take one. Depends on how big you want it. True, yeah. But I know with like dark oak, I think. Yeah, dark oak's the one where you have to have a 2x2. It can't be any smaller. Acacia sucks. You can use it in the right context. There. Okay, that's not bad. That's good. Okay. Good tree. Maybe elephant will want another one, but we'll see. Spruce on top, maybe. My personal favorite wood. Honestly, you gotta go with the classic. I gotta go with oak. Just plain old oak. I like jungle wood. Jungle wood is also good. I like that. I really like jungle. I think the only thing I like about... Not the only thing I like about. The main thing I like about acacia is the doors. They remind me of like this lake house that I used to visit sometimes. And it has that same sort of door. What does a jungle door look? Hang on. What does a jungle door look like? I don't remember. Door. Jungle looks like... That's mangrove. Oh, that's the jungle door. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, it's nice. I use jungle trapdoors for like street lights on my other my personal friend's server. It's fine. It's fun. I love the way it looks. But no, I mean by like the, you know, you got to think of the biome. I know a lot of people don't think about that, and I'm not really thinking about biomes here because, you know, we're in a city. You can't have everything match with a biome. But if you're in a biome where the color just feels right for acacia and it needs those like orange accents, then it's right. You can build a house out of acacia. Just don't have it be mainly acacia. I think the problem is that people use acacia too much and they need to use it as like accents. Be right back. I will not see you later. I'll be gone. Ending stream right now because you said that. Bye. What a funny joke. It was incredibly funny of me. All right. What did I come down here for? Think. Put on my thinking cap. Use 100% of the human brain. What am I doing? All right, I was going to... Let's build some fences. Craft some fences, rather. That's the latter half of this game's name. I remember. I know what I'm playing. It's Terraria, right? Be right back. All right. I will see you. I will still be here. All right, so let's make some fences. Definitely need a lot more than that. I made them out of dark oak. They should be jungle. They should definitely be jungle. All right, well, let me grab some more jungle saplings from, let's just use the community tree farm. It's there for a reason, right? So we'll just get some jungle wood here. Make some nice fences. We don't want it to be too restrictive though. We don't want the people for the ethical treatment of animals coming after elephant. No siree, we do not. So we're going to have a nice big enclosure for elephant. And that does include having the gates and the fences not be too restrictive. I want elephant to see the world. I want him to be able to explore his enclosure and have a grand old time doing it. Gosh, they get taller every single time. Sound like a grandparent. Oh, you get taller every single time I see you, Sonny. What were you, like, 4 feet tall? Stop growing. Stop eating food. It's unnatural. The U.S. military will want you. You better stop. What, do you play basketball or something? All right. It said 45 minutes. It's been 50, and now it says 12 minutes. Laundry's weird, man. I hate my laundry machine so much because I'll set it to wash and it'll say 55. I don't know 55 what. This is like the only time that like my math teacher from elementary school has my back. And like I get what they were saying. Like, oh, you have to have your units, have to include your units. 55 apples, 55 bananas. No. It's, they don't include a unit. I wish there was a unit. But no. When I put 55 on my laundry machine, I set a timer for 55 minutes and I come back and it says something like 7 on it. It's either minutes or degrees. Well, no, because the number keeps going down. Oh, maybe. Hang on. No, no, not degrees, because then it says 1 degree. If it were degrees, it'd say 1. It's not minutes, because when I come back and it says 1, I come back a minute later, it's still going. I come back 5 minutes later, and it finally stops. So I have no idea what the units are on my laundry machine. I'm not stupid. That's just the way it is. These things will never change. All right, let's plant some more of these. Just a couple. Washing machine minutes are weird. Yeah. Ain't that the truth? I never know if it's more efficient to break the leaves to get saplings or to just let them decay on their own. It goes at 0 minutes for half an hour. It's messed up. The laundry industry has gotta change. This is one of the most pressing issues in all of the world. Everything else can wait. Who cares about every other aspect of politics? Fix the laundry machines. It's brainwashing us. Yes! Brainwashing us to think of time differently. You know what it is? I bet it somehow connects to daylight savings. I am positive it does. Ben Franklin, I love you, bud, but you're wrong for that. You were wrong for daylight savings. There's no... It's wrong. It upsets me. And I'm aware that's like a... I know it's like a stereotypically... I don't know if this is right to say, but it's like a stereotypical thing to say that autistic people hate daylight savings. I feel like that is a stereotype that exists, and it's been like portrayed in media a lot. But do you blame them? Do you blame autistic people? What's the reason? Explain it to me. Don't send me an article. I won't read it. Explain it to me, but don't actually, because I don't want to know. All I know is that it's stupid. Why is my grandpa impression perfect? Because I had a grandpa once. I'm autistic and I agree, see. I don't know if I'm autistic. I know it's like, autism's a spectrum. You could be any degree on the spectrum. I don't know. I don't know if I am. I don't really care. It's not at like, if I am on the spectrum somewhere, it's not to a degree where it affects my life. So I am fine with either way. I just want to hate daylight savings and like trains. Is that okay? Archie, are you a grandpa? You can't go ousting my secret identity like this, clown. My secret other family in Minnesota can't know. They can't know about my secret life here. As a Minecraft streamer. They can't know! Alright, let's see. I knew it. Yeah, yeah. Keep it on the DL, on the down low, if you will. What was I in here for? Right. Okay, I have acacia. Let's put this stuff away that I don't really need. Dark oak, don't need it. Don't need, I need that. Don't need this. Don't need this. Don't need this. Might need this. Don't need this. Might need this. All right, that's good. No money for formal diagnosis. Yeah. I know that's like something that a lot of my friends have been doing. It's like, oh, I've been researching autism and it's shockingly close to me. I'm like, oh, that's cool. Good. I know people have like problems with self-diagnosis, but I feel like if there's enough symptoms and you're like, this is scarily close to me as a person, I feel like it's safe to say, like, you can just say like, yeah, I'm pretty autistic. What was I doing? Oh, right. Fences. Good show. Good show, Fences. That's such a lie. I haven't seen it. I wish I've seen it. I would like to see Fences. I know there's probably like... Is there like a free pro shot on YouTube? Like there always is. Oh, wait. I could have just spread that out. Okay. But, you know. I'll look for that after stream. Because I do want to watch Fences. I hear it's awesome. I don't know if you could tell, because I stream Minecraft, but I always say this, there's like two paths of life, especially for hobbies. For kids who did theater after high school, you either you pursue that professionally and you become like a Broadway stage actor, which some of my friends have, they major in theater and it's cool and good for them, or you become a Twitch streamer. And I saw that in like a Twitter post, and I wanted to dispute it so bad, because I'm like, okay, that's a massive generalization, I think. But then I look at myself, I'm like, yeah, it's not wrong. All right, let's see. Where should I put the gate? Probably up here, right? Let me count this out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Give them a 2-wide gateway. Kind of want it to be different than the rest of it. A little bit more of a ramp. I did theater and now I'm becoming a history teacher. Stream and also play D&D. History! That's nice. That's cool. Very cool. Good on you for kind of breaking the stereotype. Still streaming, but... Alright, I think I need more smooth stone. Yeah, history was a favorite subject of mine all throughout school as well. I think I have to take like one more history class in college. It's like a gen ed thing, but then I'm going to be done with it. And that makes me sad. Makes me very sad. History teacher's hella gay. There was a wide array of history teachers that I had in high school. That was a lie. I had a single bad history teacher. Bad in that he was not good at his job. Not in the other way. In the way that most people on the internet use the word bad these days. He didn't really care. I got a low grade in that class. I'm like, great. At least I passed and I don't have to take a class with you again. But all my other history teachers, it was a wide array of them, and it was so interesting. It's like there was one guy, my first dedicated history teacher in middle school, made me love history so much. Incredible teacher, just incredible guy, made me very passionate about the subject. I don't know, maybe if I had had better history teachers, I would have tried to pursue it as a career or something, but I didn't, so. But yeah, first history teacher was awesome, incredible. Love the guy. Second one in high school, freshman year. He was also the football coach. I feel like that's another stereotype. Is that history teachers, they're always sporty. But I disagree, because my next history teacher was the bad one, and he was like technical guy. He was like pretty much the school's closest thing to an IT guy that they had. But, yeah. It's an American thing, then? What, teachers being, like, athletic? Well, yeah, it's still a stereotype, you know. There was only one that fit that stereotype, and he was the football coach. But he was also great. Don't get me wrong. Just because he was the football coach does not mean he was a bad teacher. He was also very good. Not as good as the first one that I had in middle school, but he was a great teacher. Then I had another one who was just, like, literally just a dude. Just a guy. I can't explain his personality any more than that. He was just a guy. Just a regular dude. Nothing too great. He was chill. There's nothing wrong with him. Nothing, like, wow, this makes me really love history. Nothing like that. He was just a dude. Just a dude. Awesome. Great dude. Love that guy. And that was it. That was it for history. But I do love the subject. The thing I did not love about the subject was learning way too much about the Treaty of Versailles. I had to learn about the Treaty of Versailles like 5 times. Not a fan. I got it the first time, all right? You don't need to dedicate this many units and years to it. Okay. So I'll take this then. And I'll put it... Hang them here. Okay. That probably... That'll work. But I do want it to be... taller. You know, because I said I don't want it to be too restricting. But I feel like this is kind of liberating, right? I don't know. I'll have to ask the gorilla when I bring him here. Versailles, fine. Roman emperors. Yeah. I definitely did learn about the Roman Empire. I don't think about it at all. I don't know where that trend came from. About, oh, ask your male friends or your boyfriends if how often they think about the Roman Empire. Oh, all the time. I've never thought about it. I only started thinking about the Roman Empire because of that trend. And I think that's silly. Here we go. I do daily. Well, that makes sense because that's your field. You should think about it daily because that's what you're gonna do as your career. So keep it up, keep thinking about that. Let's put this here. There, that looks decent, right? Okay, I feel like I should put some of these like here and here so it can like feasibly hold itself up. Like 30 emperors, 3 in 1 year at the same time. Do you mean just like 3 in 1 year? Or were they genuinely just at the same time? I don't know enough about Roman history to know that. All right, here we go. That's nice. I like the way this looks. Oh, perfect. At the same time. Wow, that is cool. It does not make me want to look more into it. But yeah, that's called the three emperor year. I see. Okay, cool. Let's see if I'm still not tired enough to sleep. I mean, it makes sense. It's a pretty pretty self-explanatory name for it. It makes sense. Oops. The only thing I retained about learning about the Roman Empire was Mark Antony. I remember a lot about Mark Antony. Is it Mark Antony or is it Mark Anthony? I think I've seen both spellings. But I think it'd probably be smarter to say Anthony. Because I have a... I'm from a region. I don't know if you could tell. I'm from a region where I pronounce the name Antony as Antony. I can't say Antony. That sounds wrong. It's Antony. I don't hide where I'm from. It's like... I know a lot of people are like, oh, I gotta be so secretive about my identity on the internet. And I still am. Don't worry. I'm a little paranoid about that too. But I can't tell anybody what state I'm from or what country I live in. You can tell I'm American, so that's, you know, pretty self-explanatory. I've got the accent, I got the everything. But I was playing in like a few games of Phasmophobia and Valorant and CSGO, and on multiple occasions, I've said something. And they've been like, oh, you're from New York, aren't you? And I can't deny it. So Americanized? Or Americanified? What is it? Is it not Mark Antony? Mark Antony, American singer-songwriter. That is not what I mean. Yes, it is Mark Antony. That is what it is. It's Mark Antony. Marcus Antonius, commonly known in English as Mark Antony, was a Roman politician and general and played a critical role. Yeah. Critical role. Whoa. Yes. Marcus Antonius. It is Mark Antony. That's what I'm seeing. I'm looking at it right now. I am seeing it. It is an English translation. Commonly known in English as Mark Antony. It's Latin. I know Marcus Antonius is, but the English translation is Mark Antony. I get why you haven't heard it as much, because you're Dutch or whatever. No, sorry. I think this is... Oh, sorry, I put him on my head. You can pronounce Marcus Antonius. Why translate? I don't know. It's just the way it is. Some things will never change. But I don't know. It's fine. I have no idea why we translated it. That's like the only one I could think of. Where they do that. Wait, do other Roman emperors change their names for English? Is this one? No. Marcus Aurelius doesn't change his name. What about... I'm just typing in all the ones that I know. Oh, wow. Okay, that's a nickname. Caligula's a nickname. Also, he's a war general, not an emperor. I know that. Yes. I know. Gaius Caesar Augustus Germanicus, better known by his nickname Caligula. I had no idea that was his full name. So it's still not English, but it's a shortening of it. It looks like that's the only one with an English translation. I wonder why. I genuinely wonder why. Because, yeah, it's not like... Sorry, I put him on my head again. Why did I do that? It's not like Marcus Antonius is hard to say. It's pretty easy. I don't get it. I have no idea. Oh, well. All right. I think this is good. We can ask Elephant his opinion of this place when we bring him in. We'll see. Let's ask him. Let's see. Alright, so we need our lead. And we need our name tag. Let's just pop it right in here. Already. Elephant. I'm going to make sure that I'm spelling it correctly. Because I hate this name. Yes, Elephant. Just to be sure. Because sometimes I make silly typos and I don't realize it until later. That's pretty weird. Why one Roman guy who's translated to English? I have no idea. Not a clue. It's so weird. I genuinely wonder why they did that. All right. Well, we've got our lead. We've got our name. We're going to do my laundry. All right. I won't end. Don't you worry. We've got plenty of tasks left. That reminds me. Let me update my to-do list because we have built the gorilla enclosure. So let's chop that right off the list. Da, 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 and it's gone. Here we go. We did two whole things so far. Now we got to find a gorilla. Let's go find ourselves a gorilla. And I know just where to start. As long as it's still there. Outside of Gordius's place. Let's see if that gorilla's still there. I wonder if Gord has an emotional attachment to that gorilla. Because it doesn't seem like it moves. Every time I come by, it's there. It's like it's still going to be there. Next to that yassified Gord image. It's still there. Hey, bud. Are you tied to anything? Or you just... No, you're just here because you want to be. Okay, cool. You just like yassified Gord. That's cool, I guess. You know, good for you. Would you like to come with me? Banana. Oh, is he tamed now? He gave me hearts. You like banana? Banana. Are you tamed? I don't know how this thing works. I'm new to gorilla ownership. Do you follow me? Will you follow me if I coerce you with bananas? No. Interesting. So you gave off hearts, which I'm assuming means stop putting them on my head. I'm assuming it means I've tamed you. Let me Google this. Alex Mobs Golira. Okay. Spawn in jungle biomes. Yes. Can be tamed by feeding them bananas. Tamed gorillas can be put into two modes. Stay, which makes the gorilla stay in place, and wander, which makes the gorilla wander around aimlessly. Are you in stay mode? Whoa! Look at you! Were you already tamed and you were just in stay mode? Oh, that's why it did that, because I had him in my offhand. Okay. What mode are you in? I have to dry it the old-fashioned way, so let's hope it's dry tomorrow. Yeah. Yeah, I hang dry stuff. Just specific shirts. Like band shirts, concert shirts. I gotta hang dry that. Will you come with me? What mode are you in? Okay, so I think you're in stay mode. Maybe you are tamed. Maybe you are. Okay. It's fine. Alright, I'll find another gorilla. Yeah, pleasure doing business. I hope you enjoyed the banana. Let's find another gorilla. Dryer's in my mom's room, but she wants to sleep and I have to get up at 7:30. Yeah. Oh, you're smaller. You're not a silverback. But you are still in stay mode, aren't you? That makes sense. No dryer for me? Yeah. Understandable. Okay, so he is tamed. So those must be just Gord's gorillas. So we do have to go out and adventure and find our own. Okay, so let me go get my armor then. So we do need armor. We need to go out and about, find our own gorilla. Which is, it's fine. I don't really care. Gosh. I was just hoping it would be really easy. And like that gorilla just stayed there because it liked chilling. Because honestly, if I could get a chill gorilla, that'd be ideal. A gorchilla, some might say. That was good. That was okay. Not one of my better ones, but it was okay. Let's find a gorchilla. All right. Put on our armor. That was bad. Shut up. Did I ask? I did not. All right. Oh, yeah. I could probably put some of this stuff away, too. Like, I won't be needing this or this or this. Or, I'll put them on my head. Fine, I'll do it. I won't be needing this or this or this or this or this. I do need blocks, though. I'll just keep those on hand. Oh, boy, I'm going to sneeze. Ah, I've been trying to remember to to mute myself when I sneeze. Because when it comes through on the other side, it gets just massive and way too loud. All right. But we have our shield, we've got our adventuring gear on, and it's adventure time, indeed. Let's go to the jungle. Let's go out to the jungle and find ourselves a gorilla. Could I find some different music, too, please? It's, let's see. Let's find, there, Sonic music. Here we go. That works for me. Here we go. Gorilla time, baby! Yahoo! I'm just like that guy from that one movie. I don't remember his name. I think it was Cornelius. Cornelius Grindelman. From Rudolph. One time I had somebody tell me, oh, you have you seen Rudolph? And I was like, yeah, I've seen the original. The one with the stop motion. And they're like, oh, that's not the original. Are you stupid? Turns out they were stupid because it is the original. And anyone who says otherwise is strong. So bye. All right, to the jungle. Hello. I'm looking for a gorilla today. Where are you? Do they need trees to spawn? Is that the issue here? Okay. No gorillas here. There's a creeper though, not a fan at all. Let's see. Party rock. Pants, there we go. Watch out for us. Another one. What? I didn't put my pants on? Dang it. There we go. Maybe I was wrong to put the music on, because now I'm just distracted by how good it is. Ha! Hi, creeper. What's up, buddy? Oh, there's another one. There's another jungle. We'll explore this one. Spidey pants? Yes. I have not played Spider-Man 2 because I do not have a PS5. The only way I'm going to get a PS5 is either I like win one somehow in a giveaway or in 10 years when I can get one on eBay for $150. That's the only way I'm getting a PS5. So I've had to settle for watching gameplay of it on YouTube, which is fine. You know, watch some Jacksepticeye. It's incredible. Game looks awesome. And I've been thinking about getting it on Steam, getting the previous one on Steam, because I haven't played that one either. It's on sale right now, 40% off, and I'm not sure if I should get it because it's still $35. We'll see though. Maybe. I have ordered a PS4 controller just to game with. So I'll have like the whole experience if I do choose to buy it. But speaking of choosing? Why are these gorillas not choosing to show up? Are they not choosing to like me or something? That was funny. Double kill. Okay, he just missed. That was just stupid. He was far away from me. Oh! 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 Stop it! Stop it right now! Oh, oh, oops, there we go. Can they climb vines? There's so many. There's so many. Why are there so many? Okay. There's more jungle over here. Let's go. We're not stopping until we find a gorilla. Ooh, what's this? Is this somebody's house? Or is it like an NPC thing? What was that? Okay, it was a fly. Oh. Wait. Wait a minute. I didn't know that. That acts as a gust of wind. Okay, I don't want to blow it up. There's a creeper. I just noticed that. I do not want to blow up whatever that is. Is that man-made? Or am I being silly? What if I drop down there and just... Hey, can you explode, please? Creeper, please? You take them all out. I'll be your best friend. Oh! Didn't shield in time. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Can I get to a thing, please? Please. 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 Shoot! Oh. 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 Up. Up. I need up. I need up. Uppies. Oh. 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 If not for these pants, I would be super dead. Oh, so dead I would be. Oh. At least most of them are gone. Okay, most of them are gone. Just sit up here and regain health. Okay. Is that, that's Casa del Beefman over there. Okay. So we're not too far out from civilization. Ooh. Man. Close, though. Very close. Very close. Let me turn this down a little bit. Just a little bit. That's a little bit enough. All right. Ooh. Are they still on me? Man, they have a wide range. All right. Imagine almost dying. Couldn't be me. Yeah, well, you're not in the zombie apocalypse, are you? Yeah. It's just a hut. Not an NPC thing, not a lore thing, just a hut. Which is fine, I guess. That's a clip of me getting obliterated, yeah. Ow! Rude! Man's rude as hell. Alright. Did I see some light over there? What is that? I gotta check that out. There's a Skeleboy by it, but that's fine. That's what I'm talking about. That's the castle. I think that might be the castle, because there's a bridge over there that I'm... Yeah, I made that bridge. That's the castle where I died. It's the specific clip. Clip? No, it's the specific place I died to a seven deadly sin. A seven deadly sin. I'm so smart. I so know grammar and stuff. Alright. Let's head over to where the light is. Just to explore. But we can't forget our main objective. Gorilla. Gorilla, gorilla, gorilla. Gorilla, 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 gorilla. I wish that were like a grammatically correct sentence. Like the way that buffalo, 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 buffalo is a grammatically correct sentence. Just saying buffalo 5 times in a row is technically grammatically correct. I don't remember the specific logic of how it is, but I just know it is. Ow. Rude. See, I hear more. I hear more. Come here, come here. Come on. I should get a better sword than just stone. Alright, let's see. What are you? What is this? What is this? I don't know what that was. It's gone now. Is there light? Oh, because of a spawner. Oh. Hello? There's a lot of capuchin monkeys around here. I see. Ah. You are what's been hitting me. Stop doing that. Rude. I hate it. I hate you! Here we go. Monkey. Not the monkey we're looking for. And we're not even looking for a monkey. We're looking for an ape. Hello. Bye-bye. Creeper. That's not a monkey. Definitely not the ape we're looking for. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Alright. I don't know if they respawn or something. What is this? What is this? What is this? It's a spawner. looks like an untorched spawner. Oh, a monkey spawner. I'll save you, monkey. Oh, they attack. Oh, you're actually awesome. Oh, you're awesome. Monkeys are awesome. I didn't know that. Same thing, different shape. And Dutch is monkey and people monkey. That's interesting. You're not wrong. It's not an inaccurate thing to say. His apes are pretty much just monkeys without tails. I think that's like the main distinction. There's definitely more stuff that I'm just not remembering, but it's just tails. I think that's the main thing. What's that? Nothing cool. All right. More jungle. Big. Well, there are monkeys that are bigger than some apes. I'm pretty sure. Like, chimps can be pretty small. So I'm sure there's some monkeys that are bigger than chimps. And chimps are apes. It'd be so nice to have it be just daytime and nice. So I didn't have to deal with everything here, but I do. It's not. If I were a gorilla, where would I be? Some might say the jungle, but it's not, apparently. Is that towards the direction of the person's house? Maybe. Does this antenna have any significance? Like I've said before, I have not explored much of this server. I've been mostly in the safe zone. So this is all new for me. I'm gonna look it up now. Let me know. Let me know what the difference is. Tail size and naked face. Naked face. Do monkeys have hair on their face and that's a distinguishing factor and apes don't? Interesting. All right. Some more jungle over here. I think this might be, I'm just looping them back around. I'm chasing my own tail here. I don't think that's interesting. Okay, well, there has to be more. There has to be more. There has to be gorillas somewhere here. Okay, we're on the other side of the castle now. I don't know if there's still... I think as long as we avoid going inside the castle, we'll be fine. Because that's how I died last time. I went inside. I got owned by gluttony. Do I know emperor monkeys? I don't. I do not know what an emperor monkey is. Are they in the same vein of an emperor penguin? They're great. Convince me of how they're great, because I've seen some pretty lame monkeys. Look them up, they're awesome. I will. As soon as I find this ape. Okay, it doesn't look like there's as much activity. There's a few zombies, which is to be expected in the apocalypse. Mustache? Emperor monkeys have mustaches? That's awesome. Where? Okay. How to find gorilla. That's cool. Okay. Wait, I kind of dig it. I dig the idea of a monkey with a mustache. Call it a monkstache. Okay, can you stop this, please? This heinous crime of beating me to death? I'm not a fan. Not a fan at all. Big ones. Awesome. Can't wait to Google this. They better have just big old handlebars. I better not be disappointed when I look this up. Interesting. Where is it? Huh. Okay, well, hang on. Let me pause for just a second. Just a second. Expect a tweet saying how great they are. Hey man, if they're as great as they say you are, as you say they are, there we go. You'll get that tweet. Don't you worry. Do not worry about a thing. Alright. Is that more castle or am I stupid? No, that's the castle. Okay. I'll be looking. Awesome. Let's see. Chat. I gotta talk about something. Gotta find something to talk about. Let's talk about the economic and political state of the world right now. That's a pretty good low stakes conversation to have. Alright. Let's just get a bird's eye view of this place. Is that a jungle temple? Holy, it's a jungle temple. Wait, actually huge? I know it's like an offshoot, and it's not what we're here for at all, but I did not know this was here. Did not know this. Guy at my job asked me if we were participating in inflation. That's great. Have you signed the petition to increase inflation by 2%? You have? Screw you. Die. Yeah, somebody's already looted this place. Makes sense. Where's the, oh, Spencer's gone. Okay. It's just me. Lame. Ooh. Yeah, they've torn this place to shreds. Called vegan food propaganda. Yeah, I'd like to get a propaganda at one of those. Alright. Nothing in there. Let's go back to the jungle. Go back to jungle. Can vegans have pudding? Well, the answer to that question is no. How can you have your pudding if you don't eat your meat? Hey guys, if you like that joke, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Oh, there's a grave. Wait, whose grave? Whose grave have I found? This looks like a gourd. A gourd grave. Just looking at it from the side. Oh no, it's not. It's a sweet grave. I see. Oh no. I see how. I see what caused this grave. Zombies. Oh dear. Can I hold their inventory or something? I'm just gonna break it. I'll build out a little platform just in case some stuff falls. I wonder if sweet wants this stuff. I have stolen so much stuff from Sweet. It's not even funny. It'd be nice to return some of it. You know what? That's what I'm doing. I'm being good. What did I get? I have no idea. Alright, cool. Well, I'll give them something. Maybe one banana. There's an ocelot. I don't think you can tame ocelots anymore, can you? That's kind of sad. I gotta be like Dora the Explorer here. If you spot a gorilla, just let me know. Keep your eyes peeled. Where do you think Swiper's hiding? I think he's in a hut. Do you see a hut? That's right. It's a hut. All right. Great times. Where? Cholera. Cholera. Zombie groans. Gross. Keep that to yourself. Ow. Why are you so buff? Oh, there's multiple. Oh. Oh, no. There better not be zombies up here. Even worse. Shoot. Go up. Did you know Dora teaches English here? That's cool. Very cool. I did not know that. That's awesome. Yeah, in America at least, it's just Spanish. It's very cool. Alright. I mean, I guess that makes sense. Does Dora also teach Spanish, or is she exclusively an English teacher in the Netherlands? Where? I'm getting pissed. I'm getting royally pissed. Where is this gorilla I've heard so much about? You want one language is overrated? Yeah, well, it's the easiest one to do. Only English? I see. That is interesting. So does she not have like an accent? I'm assuming she speaks Dutch. Over here, when she speaks English, she has an accent. Like, it's very clear. You can tell she's not from New York. She does? Yeah, it makes sense. But she has an accent? Like, no accent? If she does have an accent, what is it? Is it... Oh! Is it an English accent? Like an English accent of the Dutch language? Because here she has a Spanish accent in the English language. That'd be cool. I'm getting sick and tired. I'm getting tired of this monkey. Sorry, ape. It's an ape. It's an ape. It's an ape. Not showing his face. His beautiful, awesome face. No accent, though? Well, technically, regardless of what language you do speak, you have an accent. You have an accent. Dutch people who speak English have a very distinct Dutch accent, and that makes sense. It's pretty funny. Nice. I believe it. Freaking gorilla. I'm losing hope. I truly am. I'm truly losing hope. I don't know if I'll be able to find a gorilla. Have I explored in this direction? I don't know. We call it... Ow! Dick! Oh my gosh! What was that? Did he nail me? Just shot an absolute piss missile at me. Oh my gosh! Stop! Stop! I yield! I give up! Never mind, I live. Coal English, I see. So that's a pretty long word for coal. That's a very long word for coal. That's what I love about the Dutch language. Makes everything so dang long. What is that? I keep getting distracted by every new thing I see. But I mean, I'm not seeing any gorillas, so it seems like I might as well explore. Let's go see what that is. Manja manja. How much food do I have left? Is this just it? I just have one bread. I have bananas. I guess I'll use the bananas. Don't you dare shoot me. Don't you dare hit me. All right. Go from rooftop to rooftop just because I want to see the top of this thing. Oh, save that. Save the bread. Oof. Okay. We're running low on food, but that's okay. It's for a worthy cause. Gorilla. What is that? Excuse me? It's glowing and it's a rainbow. What are you? Be very cautious. Hello? Seal? Is it a rainbow seal? Why? Why is he in prison? What wrongs has he done? Why are you in prison, rainbow seal? Gay seal, what did you do? Is it because Heidi left you? He looks so sad. He's just laying on his side. Yeah, he's been LGBT detained. He's been caged. I don't like that. I mean, I'm sure there's a reason, but I'm not a fan. I'll say it, I'm not a fan. Cajun seals. Next, you're gonna tell me you're Cajun chicken. Yeah, that's a good one. I like that one. Which way do I go? It's this way. Set him free? There's lava. I could easily get rid of the lava, but there's still lava. What is this? Is this a base? No. Somebody's doing this. Some bad news for you. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. What is it? What? I kind of do want to set him free, but also I... You know what? I'm gonna Google it. Why would someone cage a RGB seal? Alex mobs. Ow, am I getting hit? I am. It's fine. They do, in fact, cage chicken. I know. That was a joke about the word Cajun. Cajun as in Cajun chicken. C-A-J-U-N. It was a play on that word. I am aware. I am aware that they cage chicken. Oh! Oh, my hat! They're going to take my hat! This injustice will not stand! No, it will not! I will not stand for it! Alright, let's see. Seals can survive in both land and water. Okay. Okay, you know what? Yes. Yes. I will free the seal. There's no good reason to be keeping this beautiful animal inside, caged up like this. Excuse you, Gesundheit. I will set him free. There's no reason to keep him caged up like this. He'll go down there. He'll swim free. Like the movie Free Willy, but if it were a seal. What would you call that? If Willy's a whale, then the seal would be silly. Free silly! We must free silly! Alright, let's go. Here we go. On our vision quest! I'm here, silly! Don't you worry! You'll be out in a jiffy! I'm gonna turn this all into stone. There we go. Alright, now, let's go up here, break open the cage. It's okay. You'll be fine. You have been freed. At first I was like, okay, oh, his name is Turd. Sorry. Man, they did not do you right, silly. Your name is silly in my heart, Turd. I'm sorry. You're just silly. He agrees. Look at him. He's nodding his head. He agrees. Alright, Turd. Sorry, silly. Let's get you out of here. See, if it were a normal cage with, like, nothing around it, I'd be like, okay, somebody's just keeping this seal here because they want a seal for an enclosure. I'll just leave it alone. But they went out of their way to build an obsidian cage above this lake and poise it above lava. This is just animal abuse. It's what it is. Turd is going free. You are going free, Turd. Be free! Yes! Be free, my young man! Go forth into the world! Enjoy! Live off the fat of the land! Be free! Thank you. I feel so great. I feel so wonderful having done that. Honestly, I may not have found elephant. Not today. But that is okay, because we have done a great service to nature by freeing Turd. Hello, Linkxerxes. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. I think this is the way back. How are you doing today, Linkxerxes? What is this? Oh, hello. This looks man-made. Is it? It certainly looks so. Okay, they'll fight each other, maybe, possibly, please. Interesting. What is this? What is this? Hang on, this is new. Great, how are you? I am doing just swell. I take it you two know each other. Oi! What are you doing on top of my building? What am I doing on top of this building? Okay, so this must all be Beefman's. What is he planning with this? What does he have? Hang on. I've been wanting to snoop around Beefman's joint for a while. First of all, I do need some food. I feel like it'd be a courtesy of me to... Oh, none of this is grown. That's weird. I feel like I should breed some more of his cows just so that he can, you know, to pay him back for the ones that I killed. So I'll breed his cows, and I'll use the remaining wheat to eat. Hello, cows. Thank you for the follow. I do appreciate it greatly. There we go. Now they're bread. And now I will make bread. Total strangers? Absolutely. I believe it. I do believe it. Alright. Let's just get a little bit more bread. Enough to tide me over on the trip back home. Oh yeah, that's right. There's a specific room that I want to explore here. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Hang on, if I can find it. What is this? Epic tunnel time. Whoa. Whoa, what is... Wait, hang on. What is this? Okay, there's that. Is this a mine? Maybe. Wait a dang minute. Please call an adult or employee if stuck. Monkey Mayhem. Monkey Mayhem was here? Interesting. Very interesting. You have banana? That's true, but they... Here, look at this. Okay, it's not a good example because it fills up my hunger completely. But if, like, in a life or death situation, banana is not going to save me. It is not going to be enough to regen. That's interesting. Monkey Mayhem was here. Very interesting. Let's check out the room over here. Where was it? It was, had, like, some label on it. Golden carrot on top. Yes. Yes, sir. Couldn't agree more. I could, but I won't. Where was that room? It said, like, VIP only. Could have sworn it was in here somewhere. But I'm not finding it. Hello. Hello. Hey up, Mary. King. New Meridian. Don't touch. Don't touch King. That's fair. I won't touch King. It's just business. Okay. I'm gonna leave that alone. For no reason. It's fine. What is back here? Hello. Okay, back into it's just business. Makes sense. Oh, this is just in a regular building. I'm assuming a crocodile will attack me, so I'm gonna leave now. He's hissing. Yeah, I don't think he likes me very much. Interesting. King likes you? That's not King, that's it's just business. I've met King before, and... Let's see, I think he's in here somewhere. I do believe he's in here. Think? Yes, that's him. See, you can tell it's King because he's got his little crown on his head. Look at that. I think maybe he got that by just being name tagged as King. Maybe. So yeah, that's King. We've met before. And where is the VIP section? I saw it and I didn't go into it because it said like, oh, VIPs only. Where is it though? You're right, he did empty out all of this area down here. For some reason. I don't know why Beefman does anything. He's a man of mystery. So this is the feeding pit. This is how you get into King's enclosure, I think. Yep, there he is. There he is over there. Still there. Only VIP can find it, I guess. Nepotism, yeah. That's what nepotism is. I found it so easily. I found it on accident last time. I have no idea where it is, though. Let's see. I don't think it's in there. Wait, there was another room that I wanted to explore. Over here. Yeah, this. First of all, what's with these? What are these? What is this block called? It's a... It's from the Sons of Sins Iron Oven block. Okay, so that's the same mod that the Seven Deadly Sins came from. Hello! Speaking of animal abuse, holy. Oh my goodness. Wow. Whoa. Two floors of sheep cruelty. Is it like you kill them or you shear them? I wonder. Ah, both. it would seem to be both. Okay, if I go in there, I will die. So, I'm not doing that. What's up here? Jail. They are in jail. They have committed heinous war crimes and therefore they must be imprisoned. Yes. Interesting. Love that. Alright. Oh, there it is. VIP only. That must mean me. Pay up, Mary. And I neglected to go down here last time. So what is down here? Ooh. Hello? Hello? What is this? What is this gadget? What is this gizmo? I'm gonna pull the lever. Oh. Oh, I'm still too tall to go through. Oh wait, no, I'm not. Interesting. But I don't have, what is that? What is that? It's a lantern. Am I in someone's, no! No, I'm not. This is a natural spawn. I would never go into somebody's abode without permission. Am I robbing someone? That I'm definitely not doing. I'm just snooping because I love to snoop and I love knowing what things are. I have no idea what Beefman's doing here. He's got his own agenda and I don't know what it is. Kronk? Yes, you are right. It is Kronk. Pull the lever, Kronk! Wrong lever! I can't do an Eartha Kitt impression. Don't worry, man, I'm homeless. It's not my house. I was wondering about that. I saw another house, like, outside of the safe zone. And I was wondering, is this Clown's house? Because it had a catfish and a fountain in it. And I thought I had heard you talking about that catfish. I don't remember what its name was. It was like Gerald or something. Jeremiah, maybe? I don't know. But I thought, is this Clown's house? Apparently not. You are homeless. Oh, man. Are you ever planning on building a base, Clown? What is this? I have no idea. I have no idea what this... What is Beefman doing? Catfish is by the... There's like a whole restored building with a catfish in it. The beetle? Yeah, I'm talking about a different one. By the way, that's gone. It's lost. Jernard, or however you say his name, he's gone. I looked there earlier today. He's not there. The catfish is gone. I didn't do it. Don't pin it on me, but the catfish is gone. Jernard is gone. Very sad. Want to build, but there's no places to build? Well, you could probably build here. It's a little small, but there's like nobody using this area. So you could build there. You could also build... I don't know. Probably if you ask Gord, who I think built that, you could probably clear out this and clear out this, and you could build right here in this plot. But it would cover up Monkey Mayhem's building. Which, to be fair, who cares? Who took him? I have no idea. Let's see. Let me just make sure that I'm not like hallucinating. Nope, he's not here. All the Smorfs are here, but Jernard is not. It's so sad. Is that your grave? I think that's your grave. How do I get down there? Hang on. Oh, is it with the scaffolding? Okay, I see. He's gone, Clown! Somebody took him! Somebody took our precious man! Yeah, it's you. Can I break this grave? Do I have your permission to break this grave? I'll give you whatever comes out. Oh, you want this coarse dirt? You can have that coarse dirt. And we had... we had a turtle. That's right! The turtle's gone too! That is so bizarre! It's great. Not just any dirt. Coarse dirt. Harder to come by this stuff. Very difficult to acquire. Alright. Well, I didn't accomplish all of my goals because I didn't find... Did not find a gorilla. This stream, which is unfortunate. Very unfortunate. We take all this stuff off. Here we go. Put this guy over here. Ditch this in here. He's so sad. Is it in the chest? Oh, Jernard? I'm gonna get on to find out what his name is. Jernard? Or the tortoise? Turtle. I don't know. It might be in the chest. I didn't check. You know my catfish's name? Right. Alright, let's just put this, I'll just throw this here for now, so I am allowed to outro. Okay. There we go. That has been today's stream. Kind of weird, because Finn Soli earlier today asked me, Hey, Archie O'Grady, you going to be on Crimecraft today? Because I want to sell you alcohol. Want to sell you some hooch, sell you some booze, sell you some liquid courage. They didn't show up at all. I've been alone this whole time. Unbelievable, Finn Soli. How could you betray me like this? Anyways, I have to dip. Hope you've enjoyed the stream. Probably next stream will be Friday, as per usual. Probably won't be Bed Wars Friday, though, because I feel like I'm legally inclined to go and find Gorilla. I gotta find a gorilla. So that's probably what next stream's gonna be. I'm gonna, like, research better ways to find a gorilla, but yeah, that is it for this stream. I hope you enjoyed, and I will catch you in the next one. Oh yeah, socials, that's where I exist, everywhere on the internet, all three YouTube channels, all but Twitter, Instagram, TikTok. I put a letterbox down there now, and that's all there. So until next time, bye-bye.